Okay, here's a who knew story. Hazardous waste was the draw for what turned out to be a massive crowd over the weekend in El Paso County.
People lined up for miles and ended up waiting for hours, and many of them were not happy about all that. Bill Folsom looking into what happened and if there are plans to prevent this from happening again.
Yeah, the county was holding a special drop-off for items that they do not always accept. That's TVs, mattresses, and tires. There are other drop-offs around, but you pay. This was free, and the number who showed up went far beyond what hazardous waste managers ever expected.
Bumper to bumper. Video from a driver in a miles-long line of cars waiting to make a drop-off at El Paso County Hazardous Waste.
I apologize to anybody that had to wait in line. Certainly, it wasn't meant to be that way. We're a victim of our own success to some point.
Day to day, the center accepts things like old paint and household chemicals.
And certainly, we want people to come out and bring their hazardous waste. We don't want it in the landfill. We don't want people frustrated.
But there were some frustrated with these lines, a special event for tires, mattresses, and TVs. Here's a portion of the reason why. This massive pile of old TVs is just around 10 to 20% of drop-offs that happened on Saturday. 80,000 pounds of TVs in one day. That's about a fifth of the center's typical yearly total of household waste.
It was a lot of TVs.
In addition, they got 1,000 tires and 500 mattresses. While still moving out all the waste from the weekend, there's also thought going into a better plan for the future. An online sign-up is likely.
So that we can kind of space people out a little bit more and judge how many people we have so that we can be prepared for that.
Okay, people who waited saved a lot of money on recycle fees they would have paid elsewhere. It's costing the county around $40,000 to keep those TVs out of the landfill. Thousands more for all those mattresses and tires. Rob?
Wow. Thank you, Bill.